You just play epic sax guy when you're in life round to the everyone on the server. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Got to do it.
It's
epic sax guy.
It's great.
Is the one.
It is the music I want to knife to. That sounds a little bit sinister, but whatever. We're jumping into the match. We got Mobility versus iBuy Power.
Okay.
Mobility starting off CT.
Yeah, that's big for them. That's really important. But you know, they started off CT, but they need to win the pistol as well, and the anti ecos. So it's gonna be an interesting first round, especially as I mean, iBuy Power have always had sharp tactics. So, look at this four-man push on the CT, down banana.
I love this. A bit of a gamble, actually, for Mobility, but it's something that can really pay off. You get the fast info, maybe you clash into them like we saw there, and a bunch of frags happen. Hopefully it goes your way. It's a nice little gamble there for Mobility. They do manage to execute Skadoodle there over by the logs, bringing it to a three-on-three situation. And the bomb is actually tidily down very soon as it gets planted there. On the A bomb site. They got a setup here. It's pretty good setup. One guy graveyard, one guy site, and one guy in the B house here. So it's going to be down to some team play from Mobility as they move in here to actually make this retake happen. Good little pick off there. Sit up on the swag. Sit up gets another one onto Dace as well. Steel is left alone. 69 help, that bomb is kicking away. They want to sort of go for the defuse. And wow, Sip is actually going to be able to take down Steel. And that, does he have enough time? Does he have enough time? Yes, he does. He has enough time. He's going to get that defuse. And Mobility will take the pistol round, a much-needed pistol round against, on paper, what should be a far stronger team.
That was really interesting because, obviously, we saw Mobility went for the four-man push on Banana, but the iBuy Power team weren't able to discern just how many people were on Banana. They did get an early pick from the remaining guy on the A-bomb site, but they were so slow to take the site because they had no idea how many CTs were left, that the CTs managed to rotate all the way back to the arch area before the bomb got planted, and they managed to take that round, which was a really important one. So back with a more traditional round here for Mobility. They've got two people on B, got the shotgun in the apps, and that's Swag's head ripped off.
Look at the nades though, from iBuy Power. They bought two smokes and two flashes, and otherwise there's not a huge investment in pities in there. But it looks like they won't actually get to do whatever they were intending to because of Mobility. Alright, push down to the car here on Banana and Sandbags. That middle of the road, that's the very NIP smoke, that one, to defend Banana. And it just easily is taken by Mobility there.
Yeah, they didn't get to execute that smoke from the CTs. Pretty much cancelled all their plans. And we are through to the third round here. So we have a force buy coming out from iBuy Power. They're not going to wait for the last round. Looks like they might try and surprise the CTs here. I'm wondering if they're going to try and bum rush the B bomb site here, or are they just going to go for some stand picks? We'll see. But again, there's a four-man push here from Mobility down Banana.
Love this. I love it. It's so ballsy. It's so over the top. It's beautiful to see. And they're going to be racking up the kills. It's actually quite an even trade here. And that's really going to throw some craziness to the mix now as we have a 2-1-3 situation. iBuy Power by far coming out the better of this trade. But there is Stanislaw waiting closely with the mag. Gets the second shot onto Swag. And that's the 1-on-2 situation there. We sit off with 8 points of health remaining and a famash. This is going to be very difficult.
I think this was really bad for Mobility, actually. They obviously expected the eco from iBuy Power, which is why they went 4 people down Banana. But they created a final for themselves versus AKs and Galils, and it didn't go in their favor. And Sidoff here is on 8 HP. I mean, he's got to save his gun here. He is lucky he didn't extend through to mid, because he would have been picked by Dazed. But I mean, that was, I guess it was just, you know, one of those times where other team's decision has trumped yours, basically. I mean, yeah, it could have gone their way with that banana push, but the purpose of that banana push was an anti-eco, and it wasn't an anti-eco, it was a force buy by iBuy Power, a surprise force buy, which definitely paid off for them, and they find themselves in a 1-2 round situation here.
I think they got the bomb down in the first round, so I think that's how they're able to afford that buy so early, and you don't usually see that four-man push. I want to say that it's something that they will do more of. Maybe they'll calm it down a little bit to the three-man. The three-man's very standard to get that. They got that deep smoke unlocked, so we can see that they're very, very proactive, very focused on the aggression there. But look at how far pushed the mobility are all over the map, not just Banana, but also in and out of apartments in second mid. They're all over the place, and Ibo Power really suffering there. Steel gets dropped, and I love the kind of counter boost, or rather the counter smoke boost, if you will, over here to catch someone who's waiting by car. But there goes the re-smoke in front of the logs. They could even leave Stanislaw there at this point, just hiding in that position. But Skadoodle, of course, he can see over the smoke. He sees all right now.
This is burning a lot of time for the iBP Power. Finally, going to kick on Banana, but can they push? We've got a sit off retreating to the B bomb site here while his teammates rotate through to CT spawn. Got one person remaining on A, will be a late rotator, and Swag looking for the flank as well.
There you go, AZK going to go down. Actually, used the hole so far coming in from ability, putting it down to just Swag. And he's actually, oh, he's got no armor on him, actually. So, yeah, the Swag is going to be very hard-pressed to actually make this work. But they are pretty low on average here. The Swag, he's got no time, actually. 12 seconds, 10 seconds, in fact. No time at all to make this happen. So, looks like Mobility will take another round here. And the money situation, let's check out the money right now and see how things are going on that front. We can see that iBP Power is definitely a little worse for wear when it comes to money right now.
So I expect the IBPs will eco with Swag with the 1AK. Does choose to buy armor, which obviously makes perfect sense. Daze has gone for full armor and two flashbangs, which leaves him money-wise on a par with Swag as well. So it's a reasonable buy there. And Steel just gets naded into oblivion straight away here.
And they are making their push up Banana with these weapons. AK on Swag, he's going to get the pick there. Will he get the weapon? That's another story. The smoke does go down, and in fact, Daze with the pistol going to take down Sidoff. And in they come charging in. Zek trying to spray him down, gets two, gets three. There's another one there. Skadoodle will take him out. But Skadoodle, he's going to get the plant. That's all they really wanted in this situation. He's got an M4 now. He's going to make this. He's got a one-on-one. He had to win it, and he couldn't. It will be the defuse there from Ability, but that was heavy losses sustained when it comes to the rebuys they're looking at and the extra money that's going to be on the side of iBP Power. So great stuff there.
Yeah, iBP Power will be able to buy this round, and with Mobility Gaming replenishing their lost weapons, they're going to be poor after this, so they need to win this round as well. iBP Power with 1 out of 5 rounds so far, so not doing terrible on a T side of Inferno. They are keeping the CT money reasonably low, so if they take this round, then that might mean another 2 rounds afterwards.
Again, the 4-man push down Banana. They're doing it again, and they actually have started from pushing down mid. These are just incredibly crazy plays, very unorthodox, and we're yet to see it really pay off for them as they do go down 2 players and completely left a wide open here for iBP Power to abuse. I'm quite taking their time getting onto the bomb site, but getting the frags pretty easily as they do arrive in dribs and drabs towards the A side of the map. Zek in the bomb site though, unexpected position, does only get one though, so Sidoff has way too much work to do.
Yeah, I don't know what the advantages of a 4-man push down are versus a 3-man push, because there's only so much room for all the bodies. I suppose you have additional grenades as well, but one important thing to note is iBP Power have not yet twigged that they have 4 people down there, because every time they've done a 4-man push, apart from the pistol round, including the pistol round as well, they've picked the remaining guy on A very, very quickly. Obviously, I suppose he's having to glean some information sooner rather than later so they can see if they need to rotate. But each time they get picked, but iBP Power have no idea that the A bomb site is left for the studio. So if they continue doing this format, it should become apparent later on. And we do see a force by here from Ability. They've got Stanislaw with a Nova on the mortar bag. Playing up close and personal. We've got Zek with the CZ playing. Also the close angles here on the mid area, so we'll see what Mobility can do with this. But if they lose this round, then they are going to be in trouble.
Denied into the balcony there. Mobility taking control of the best they can, trying to fight for it. Slip, great opportunistic play there, taking out Steel as he popped out of mid there in front of him. Doodle in a good position. Going to capitalize with a pick onto Slip. Putting it to a 3-on-3 situation. So we're looking at what could be a plant here for iBuyPower, what will be a plant here for iBuyPower. But ultimately, we have an attack coming in from three sides. Swag to eliminate the threat from one of those sides. But Sidoff and Stanislaw remain.
An M4 and a Nova. What do you do in this situation? I mean, there are weapons on the floor. There are AKs around the area that could be picked up, but it's not going to happen.
One HP. Gutting. Absolutely gutted. He must be going to go for the save now. That kind of tells him everything he needs to know. It's the four-man thing. I've been trying to like think about it. And I really... Maybe what they're going for is the fact that they want to put... They don't want to just smoke logs. They actually want to push out into mid from Banana to kind of come behind them. But at the same time, you only need three people to even do that anyway. Because if you then leave one guy on A, and he's got no one to play with, then there's no one to counter flash in, there's no one to team play with, and that's kind of what you need in defensive setups. Whereas you can have, you always need an even number really where possible. Whereas when you're attacking, it doesn't matter to have that so much because you're, you know, running in for the trades constantly, so it's fine. But it's, I don't know, it's weird, it's quite strange.
I feel like it's one of those tactics where they know they're up against a better team, so they're trying to kind of just batter them, basically, and kind of brute force. It's like they're brute forcing down Banana, but it's not always going their way so far.
They have three. Oh, okay, they're on pistols. Exactly. Of course, they're on pistols now. But I was gonna say, if they do a setup like this on the gun round, that'd be so weird as well. Like three guys on the site with their weapons. But of course, they are rocking the pistols. Sit off with the M4, and we have a methodical push up mid here from iBuyPower as they try to make sure that nothing goes wrong. They keep as many people alive as they can, really bank that money. In they go. Sit off there. He's got the M4 on the A bomb site. Goes down with ESO. Pretty big big kill coming in there from Slip, though, onto AZK, making iBuyPower suffer some losses. Bomb does go down. Slip with the AK now. Can certainly cause some havoc here with that.
I think this will be a save now from Slip. I think it was a question of if his teammate, because his teammate only had a P250 on him, so it's a case of if his teammate gets a pick and manages to pick up a weapon, then they're in a better position to push with the 2-1-2. Otherwise, if he dies, save the AK.
Yeah, definitely. So we're going to see a 4-4 scoreline here as iBuyPower start to climb back and actually tie up the game for the first time. Ability, do you feel like their lead is going to be short-lived and something that's fleeting? Or
I think it depends. I mean, you could say they've been overextending themselves as the four-man pushes down Banana. So, but the thing is, I feel like they fear if they play too passive, then iBuyPower will eat them alive. So they need to find the right balance. Whether they'll do that or not, we'll have to wait and see.
I mean, the three-man thing with down Banana with the timings is like perfectly fine. I'm still like wondering why the extra player. Cause three-man is very common in the European team specifically. Perhaps we'll have to do some digging, James, into the American scene, the American styles, and see if we can make some sense of it.
Well, we're going to have some weeks of content to review.
That's very true. The Ability right now have a very standard setup. This is I think the most standard setup we've seen from them on a Baron versus a Baron. But the problem for them is that they're actually kind of low on nades. Their buy is pretty weak overall. And it's like a good pick on the Swag, though. So Swag out of the picture right now. And iBuyPower have to make a call very soon as to what they really want to commit towards. And looks like they're trying to just push their way up slowly to mid. And a Slip with a very timely peek there. Definitely risky, but definitely paid off. And now falling back, and all of a sudden, iBuyPower down to three players.
It was indeed risky because on a normal day, AZK would have seen his shadow before he managed to see AZK. But it's difficult to say what AZK could see because obviously there was a smoke down. So whether he had a jump or not like he usually would is uncertain at this point. 25 seconds remaining here as the terrorist side are trying to push the A-bomb site. I think this is going to be really difficult for them to win this round. They've forced the player in library to retreat, and if they could take down the guy on site, then the bomb is going to go down here. But Steel looks the wrong way, and Davey takes him out. 10 seconds remaining here, and the flank is real. It's 3-on-2 now, and these are going to be in trouble. They're going to look to try and get the frags to win the round. Too late to plant the bomb, and it's going to be a save there from the terrorist team. Skidoodle just knocking him down as they come in one by one. But again, the T's won, Mobility won the round there, but it's basically a force buy from them for the people who died. So I do wonder if it was worth them trying to chase the terrorists after the clock. You can see Zekter's got the FAMAS and no grenades. So we've pretty much got two people on a fall by from the CT side, and the grenades are so important just to slow the terrorists down, to put them in a position like we just saw in the last round where they're running out of time trying to push a bomb site to get the bomb down. It's going to be harder for them in this round with only two smoke grenades on five players. Sorry, three smoke grenades.
Working on our control, as is the standard on this map. Get that apartment under control, get that banana under control, and I would love to see the push into mid, forcing mobility all the way back towards, you know, library, CT arch, graveyard, and then, you know, leaving so much obscurity there that mobility really cannot know what is going on. That is so strong. It's hard, it's delicate, it's very, very fragile to achieve that. Some teams are quite good at doing it, but it can be very powerful. There are some teams who excel at defending in positions like that, like NIP, but generally speaking, it's quite difficult to deal with. To fall back onto. And you can see that Ivo Power are actually working their way through, and even DaZe will make a pick up there. DaZe probably going to continue to hang around to cause some trouble. We're going to have ourselves a split here. Four men onto the bomb site from Banana, making their way up now. Here's Stanislaw getting some kind of flashes in from the teammates, spraying them down. There's extra bullets helping massively. And there comes the TZ frag for the triple, and it's Swag just left by himself against three players. The one-on-one not found there for Swag, and that is going to be the round there for Mobility, who go 6-4, and they are not looking like they're showing any signs of weakness at this point in either power. They need to find some better options.
That was great positioning on Banana on the other side of the smoke. I mean, it's risky because obviously you could get sprayed down there very easily, but in that situation where the nades are coming in and they're going to be pushing facing the other way, it's a very strong position if you can snap quickly and take people out as they come in. Because from a team side point of view, as you're at a disadvantage when you're coming out of smoke like that, and it's going to be really hard for you to communicate where the person killing you is, even if you see him through that. So great play there by the CT. Making up an event as well, which is really important on any map as a CT player.
And here they go, trying to make their way up there. But the stop from Baby is very strong, a triple coming out from him. And Iowa Power still struggling to make ground work. You go with a great double there. Look at that quick switch. They're looking for that next frag. And it's going to get shut down. 7-4. Mobility seem to be finding. They are winning these fights. And on these pushes from Iowa Power, these just, you know, straight up rushes, they're getting the counter flashes in at the key moments, and they're just executing. It looks like Mobility, it's simple, but it's tight.
That was unfortunate that Skadoodle, he wasn't able to shoot there because he pulled out his knife for a second, and his AK was still on the warm-up before he could fire it. You know, two frags in that part of the map, in that part of the map time, with two players remaining, you can't always expect him to be on the B bomb site, which he may have done initially, and then, you know, he pulled his weapon back out pretty quickly, but it was too late and he wasn't able to defend himself from that. So it could have been a great clutch round, cut short, but we've got two fast eco kills here for iBuy Power, and a bomb site here.
Yeah, certainly, and it's going to look pretty desperate now for Mobility, because, okay, the bomb's going to go down. They do have some weapons behind them. The status of work on ACK takes him out. They're actually, you know, racking up the kills right now, as looks like, I don't know quite which way to look, and it's just, before you know it, they're all just down. What a wonderful 2v4 we just saw. Iber Power, I mean, perhaps they didn't have quite the time they needed to really get in position.
Well, it's the advantage of armor versus no armor. The picks came in thick and fast there, but they were all 1v1, basically. Even taking down the guy in pit from Arch, which, I don't know, maybe there did seem to be a space of confusion there, people looking here and there in the right places. So, that unfortunate for iBuy Power, but they got their bomb plant down, which allows them to get an AWP on Skadoodle here.
Skadoodle, a fantastic AWPer. Perhaps he can get enough credit?
No, absolutely not. He does not get a final. I think partly, at least, because we're in Europe and he's in America, we don't see him as much as we'd like to.
Yeah, that's actually a massive point here. I mean, like you and I, James, we don't get to see, unless we watch demos, that much in the way of American Counter-Strike, unless they go to an international LAN where all the teams are present.
And yeah, the hours just don't exactly allow it, basically.
And Mobility going to be pushed to another here on B. They've been very successful so far. Look at this, it's a dry rush. They wanted to go in without any nades. There's a contact push here. And so far, they're making the frags actually work out in their favor. And then, are they actually able to do this? They are going to get the player down there. It was Sidoff who was kind of a massive thorn in the side of that rush. And slowing things down massively. Rotation coming in and the spray through the smoke.
He's strong. 1 HP here.
Oh, the nade comes in. And finishing him off. And that's the bomb drop there. 30 seconds left for Swag to find 3 kills. And iBuyPower need these rounds. It is getting really bad for them now. Swag going to find 1 kill. Good damage through the smoke there from Swag. 20 seconds on the clock though. And there he is, taken down by Slip at the end of the round for that 9-4 scoreline. And Mobility are absolutely crushing iBuyPower right now. And it's not even looking that close on some of these rounds that they're winning. Like, that was a 3v1 right there. We've seen quite a few of those.
The Americans really know their angles through smokes,
yeah,
and through doors, etc. Like we saw on catch. Like, that's one thing worth noting. Not to say the Europeans don't, but the Americans are really making good use of it. I mean, we saw an excellent spray down from CT all the way through to the fountain area of the site, which almost took out 2 players. I mean, it killed one and left one on 1 HP. So.
Just as you were saying that, James, we just saw the pinnacle of just spray and smoke days.
As if by magic.
It just, that did seem magical. That
it's
was
like
too
an,
good
it's like
to
an infomercial. Where's Billy Mays?
And here we go, we got 2 players left now. Mobility kind of chiming with a bunch of frags. As it is chaos, as iBuyPower make their intentions known to push in on top of that B bomb site, they've punched themselves a hole into the site. But actually, Mobility kind of falling back, trying to make sure they don't get killed before their teammates arrive, and actually seeking out those frags. We're going to see Dave, you know, finding himself in a 1-on-2 at the moment. He's got the bomb, 40 seconds left. Is he just going to go for that A bomb site? Looks like it. And Mobility now, that at some point, after a few seconds, they have to realize he can be anywhere. He can come back to B or he can be on A. They have to split up. Very smart stuff from Dazed there. We can see that is coming into effect here. And Stannis, the sigh.
He's like,
that
are
sigh.
You serious?
Stannis not impressed by this. And Dazed after the plant, going to cycle back through quad here. Looking for the angle. Takes him down. Davey to fall as Dazed now goes 1-on-1 against Zek. They need this round badly right now. Oh, can they make it happen? Dazed gonna pick up the kill and get that round for iBuyPower.
I think Zek thought he was behind the truck because he was running towards the truck with a grenade out, which was
man, that's fine.
Not something you see very often in a 1v1 situation. So I think he was completely taken by surprise there. So that's a very nice win there for iBuyPower to bring it to 9-5.
So just giggling a bit about that side. It's just
that side was comedy gold.
It was brilliant. I love it.
So we've got 2 players in this last round on the CT side with only pistols, no primary weapons here. So let's have a look at the kind of positions they're taking. We've got Stanislaw taking the sneaky position on a B-bomb site, and we have Slip in CT app, sorry, with the P-shooter, which is $500 now. Managed to get the kill though, and it is going to be a 3v5, and Mobility still with only 2 rifles here. Ah, they picked up an AK actually.
Yeah, I mean, it's they're only 1 player down, but...
Oh, the flank.
Ooh, Stanislaw coming in from behind, needs to make these kills happen. Element of surprise gone, doesn't make a kill happen. Zek moves through the smoke, gets a double, looking for the spray down for the third, but it's not going to go his way. And 9-6 will be the score of the first half. Mobility. They're actually coming into their own right now. That looked really good for them. That looked fantastic.
Well, 9-6 is a good recovery there for iBuyPower as well. So it's anyone's game at the moment, I believe. And I think if Mobility really need to win this pistol and keep iBuyPower as poor as possible, so they can't buy power. Because obviously, as we mentioned before, their CT side is very strong. So they're going to need to keep it as weak as possible. Otherwise, they may get run over here. But then again, we have to see what kind of strategies they have for this round. And we're on the beat right now, and they're just going to go down with his whole body exposed on the car there. Trying to see the team rushes that nice barrel flash, but they heard it, and only one of the three players got flashed there on the T side. Jumping sees that OP takes out the doodle, and that is the bomb site taken. The bomb is down, so they're going to be able to buy on the third round at the very least. And Steel and AZK, with nothing to lose here, are going to go for the bomb site.
And in they go indeed. Both through pool here. Players on the left, on the right. Cabin behind in the side. It's just, they have to look everywhere right now. It is too difficult, surely, to pull this off. There you go, Steel now. He stands alone. Don't find too much.
Triangle of Doom was slowly closing around him.
Yeah. But you know what, actually? You know, we saw the jumping CZ there. The thing is, right, about the Glock armor, one of the reasons why it's so good is because it's incredibly hard to actually win a fight USP versus Glock when it's just like hitting shots into the armor. And so if you're actually jumping in their face, it's so hard for them to headshot you. It is unreal how difficult it is. They can just be jumping around, and that's one of the things that really makes the Glock very dangerous at close ranges with the armor, is it's on the pistol rounds. So we really saw that coming to play there. Skadoodle actually looked pretty hot in the shots also there, but he just wasn't able to deal with that.
We've got a reasonable CT approach here. No crazy stuff yet. So mobility being very patient, just keeping map control, making sure no flanks come in, and it looks like just making sure that the CTs didn't push to banana, and they're going to push towards A as a solid five. We can see if Steel gets a pick here. If they get too close, it will be a one-shot there for the future. Well, I've managed to get one. AZK does get a trade kill when Slip takes down Steel. Archer, two of them get picked out with a 5-7.
That is big.
That is why you picked that over the CZ in certain situations. They're going to have fire right as well. And there's another 5-7 kill from Swag. And they have been eco'd by the iBuy Power team. Now they're going to be in trouble. Do they? Well, looking at the money on the T side here, I think they have to. I was going to say that I think they have to eco and go for the full buy next run, but it looks like they're going to force with an AK, a Galil, and pistol armor. So obviously this is a much less than ideal situation here, but they're expecting anti-eco weapons from iBuy Power, and they are right. Steel with an MP9, Swag of the MAC-10 from the previous run, and they're going to look to break the CC economy here.
Yeah, this is a big economy play. It's one of those spots where it's uncomfortable for you, but the fact that you're thinking, all right, we know that if we win this round, that we're gonna be in so much of a more advantageous position than they will be. So it's not worth waiting. And a lot of teams like to do this risk, just keeping the pressure on the economy. Because even if they don't win it, even if they just get like a bunch of kills, that still it has a similar effect on really taxing their economy and never really getting the setups that iBuy Power necessarily want. And vice versa. So it's cool to see these aggressive plays. Always got a lot of action, and they are moving their way.
Swag's gonna have to defend
right
on his own with a Mac 10.
So look, see if he's able to deliver the goods here with that Mac 10. And in they go, completely blind through the smoke, popping, losing. The Swag just laying into them through the smoke, and Days Long Range as well. And they're actually just getting all the kills they need. Dave is left alone. And actually, he's going to pick up a kill there, putting it to a 1-on-2. The bomb taken away. This might just work for him. 9 health, though. Oh, finally. He does go down.
Why did he jump? I think he was trying to get onto the barrels there.
I don't know. It's a weird angle.
Because he rendered himself unable to shoot. I think it was just unfortunate timing there. Like, really unfortunate timing. Because he had a distinct advantage in having an AK. Having an AK there over his opponent, but you know, it's just timing really cost him the round there.
Yeah, it was a good push though, and that I cannot believe how long Swag survived with the submachine gun there. That was pretty insane. We're gonna see the pistols coming out. We've got two Molotovs there, two smokes, and a CZ and a PD50. So this is going to be very interesting here for mobility, exactly what they have in store over on the B bomb site. But they might just get shut down. There's a player on sandbags right now. So and Swag and Days are on this setup. This is going to be very dangerous. And Days goes down. And in comes Swag from behind the sandbags. And they all fall one after another. And they can't even get their Molotov smoke play really going because iBuy Power have that presence of banana for the deny.
10-9 to iBuy Power. We're going to see the buy round here from Mobility now. Both teams full buy. Interested to see A, what the iBuy Power team do here. We've got Swag and Days with the Molotov, so if they're playing B, we're going to see that double flame carpet here. Let's just see where Days is going. He's going towards B, and so is Swag. So here's a double Molotov, you see. One goes far, one goes close, so any C2 can run through it. Sorry, any T2 can run through it. Most of the time, we'll just get burned to the crisp. Get a good spawn, but out by the CTs anyway, and they clear down Banana. Three remaining for mobility, and they've only got one option at the moment.
Really like this. We've seen that deep smoke on Banana there, and you know, slowly but surely they're going to get in that position. It's going to allow Dave to just like stay up close, and for you know his teammate to just fall back around if he really wants to. Or they can both decide to fall back.
On terrorists.
A lot of options when you have a Banana play like that, but they know for sure that the terrorists aren't working Banana, but they're not an option for them. And they are forced to mid and second mid in apartments, and that's what's actually happening right now. They're getting the kills. AZK gonna shut down Sid off there, moving on to quad, and that leaves Zek alive by himself. 28 HP though, so he's gonna fall. And let's see another round going to iBuy Power. Who were systematically just kind of shut that one down. It felt like after that Banana control, Ability didn't really have much in the way of space on the map to use.
I know it's really early, but those are the kind of match-winning rounds that Mobility were trying to avoid iBuy Power getting, which is why they went into that force buy with only two rifles a few rounds ago. But iBuy Power managed to make it work for them and find themselves on 10-10 here in a very strong position with the terror side on a full eco with a few P shooters and P250s, and CT's not building the bank just yet. They've got two plays on, well, three plays on 6,000 actually, so because it's a step in the right direction, but they really need to get through this round with minimal damage.
You can see they're just fighting their time there. Oh wow, a quick peek from Stanislaw. I think that completely caught Swag off guard, perhaps switching to the nade or something. And that is some timing that is very blessed. And we can see he's going to get the bomb down here. What is going on? Stanislaw taking down Steel. And oh, Dazed, you monster. That was key, crucial play from him to stop that bomb going down. And
it's worth mentioning there. Days, he realized that the bomb had not made it to the bomb site yet, so rather than looking for the person on the bomb site, he was holding the angle to stop the bomb from making it to the bomb site, because obviously if the bomb goes down and they take the round, that's an $800 bonus for every player. That's an extra $4,000 for the opposing team, so the priority was stopping the bomb there. So great angle from there, and it was crazy to see his teammate picked off by the P250 there.
I mean, you're doing that map on the fly there, man. That's brave. That is brave. I wouldn't dare do that.
That's why I'm here. I'm Rain Man.
Oh, good God. And then again, we're going to see that deep smoke blocking off entry to Banana. The aggressive, proactive play from iBuy Power in gathering information.
Look how close they're playing it as well. I mean, they slaughtered the opposing team when they did this, two rounds ago.
Yep.
And it's just, again, it just forces Mobility to be one-dimensional. All they can do really at the moment is
This is where Riga perhaps the kills start raiding in for Mobility, and it's a 3-on-3, but they can combine themselves to have the numbers advantage on a push onto the bomb site. And what are they going to go for this? They still have time to go to the other site if they wish. And Stanislaw is going to have to be very good to catch someone here. Not actually going to find anyone, and they're trying to be sneaky here, leaving slip there, but time is running out. Or what is the bomb actually doing? It seems like they're being a bit indecisive here. Do they go A? Do they go B? Do they just wait a lot and just make iBuy Power just go into the position? Looks like slip will pick off the frag onto Days onto the B site. So there will be the plant now behind the grill. Do you have Skadoodle and AZK coming in though from CT spawn?
Skadoodle looking for the peak, but the teeth are set up already. They have no reason to peek these angles. So this is going to be a difficult take with an AWP and only one M4.
Can they go? They go. Skadoodle with a sick shot on Stanislaw. Super quick indeed. So swift. Zek here has to make sure happens. Does take down the diffuser. Was it in time though? Looks like that defuse is going to go through regardless. And AZK going to get the round there for iBuy Power. And definitely a very important one, because we can see, you know, how close we're getting to the end of this match and how close Mobility actually are to winning themselves. They are very close to the scoreline of iBuy Power here. And
yeah, you've got to hand it to them. That was a pretty good retake. I mean, it just shows the power of Skadoodle, because 2v3, and one of you's got an AWP. I mean, that's not easy. You're not as versatile as you otherwise could be, unless it was Skadoodle and you can just snap heads. Then apparently no problem. So, Abba Power 12-10, and if they win this round, he's maybe in a bit of trouble unless they get the bomb down, then they can force.
I do like the double Molotov there on Banana, because if you delay that enough time, if they do that play, which a lot of teams do, where they send like Freiburg up Banana to take it, or Flasher, whoever it is, he's going to get stuck in the middle of those Molotovs. And
yeah,
you can just walk out and kill
it. Round as well.
It's really interesting.
I mean, sometimes with a good spawn versus a bad spawn, one T can make it up through the mini arches. But then you saw that guy got roasted by the M4s rather than the flames. And Mobility finding themselves here with only two plays remaining and no real hope of breaching a bomb site anytime soon. So Power looking to make it 13-10 here, and they're going to be in good position to win here on.
And Iowa Power picking up another round. So, what was my prediction? Was it 16-10 or 16-8?
You said 16-10, yeah. Oh. And right. I said 16-7, I believe.
Yeah.
Really, I just wanted to say a 16, but you forced the other half.
I did, because I knew I had to try to do it. I need something. I need something over you. You have math.
I need something.
Give me something, man.
You sound like a desperate
criminal. I am so desperate. But here we go. Up Banana they go. And again, the fire just illuminating the hallway here of Banana. And Dave standing loud and proud on top of the car.
Large and in charge.
Yeah, getting those headies, man. And looks like
Fag trying to work out where he can pop Flash his teammate in if he needs to.
And they don't even fall all the way back out. They're just going back from car onto sandbags and the choke point there. So, you know, very brave setups. And actually, they have a smoke coming in here, I think, from Arch. You can do that. You can actually smoke into the car so you can see their legs. There's like that smoke that you have, James, on car. You can place the smoke, guys, on the car itself, inside the car, in the driver's seat. And you can only see the legs, but hold that thought. We do have the play coming up mid here as the shield gets shut off from any kind of defense. But that is a pretty dead giveaway. Love the counter smokes coming in now, and they're kind of just blocked off. What do? They've got the stop on, and all the time that's going by, we can see how Iowa Power on the map is encroaching upon them, wrapping around them, and there's just nowhere left to go. They're just cornered. And a wonderful cleanup there by Iowa Power, who are just two rounds away from winning this now against Mobility. And the Mobility, they are broke, man. They can't get these good buys in. It is also scrappy. Three Galils.
Yeah, Mobility forcing once again. You can see they tried to force the issue on Banana there, but it's just not working out for them. The double Molotov play just works so well. And then your only other option really is the kind of three area, and then that gets naded like 5 to 10 seconds later, which you somebody get naded in the previous round as well. So I think we need to see America develop some hard counters to this iBP power play, because they do it every single match on Inferno, because no one's managed to beat them at it yet.
See some early kills getting exchanged here, mostly due to the aggression from iBP power and Mobility just being ready for it. And now Mobility being, you know, man up here in the situation, looking for that combined push onto a bomb site. And who is it we see here on the B bomb site in defense?
That's Dazed.
Dazed alone there on the B site. This is the position too, like one of the best positions to do it from. If you can get a couple kills here, you make the retake possible. Dazed, he needs to find at least two kills here. Well, I guess one can still work, but two kills would be absolutely amazing. He gets one kill, the instant headshot onto Davey, and that might just be enough. It's a 2-on-2. In goes Stanislaw, catching AZK over by Speedway, and things are not shaping up too well for Skadoodle here. But if he can show us some of those quick scoping kills that we saw previously, it's going to be great. But he's going to switch out for the Galil. Smart choice here as he runs into the site. Knows there's not much time. He's got his Nikes on here. He's got the pace set up high. And in they are, both developing to the same angle. Really good play there, switching up guns, looking for the frag, gets it. Does he have enough time?
Oh, it's going to be close.
Oh, it's going to be so close. Oh, so close, and he gets it. Unbelievable. Oh, that is an
insane round.
That but was so tight.
His positioning, he saw there were two players there, and he moved to the left, so the wall was blocking the second player, so he created a 1v1 for himself, and then the other player was forced to retreat, and then got picked when Scudoodle picked up the third weapon. So that was excellent, excellent clutch play there by Scudoodle, showing his prowess with various weapons on both sides of this map.
Oh, so nice tag.
Has fallen to the flames on this occasion.
Burned to a crisp. And Scudoodle going down there. He only managed to tag down the floor. It's so early in the round, when you get your early picks like this, you can really, as a terrorist, cause a lot of issues by just playing it slow afterwards. But that's not in the cards from Ability. They're just putting the pressure on here. They're putting the pace on. As we see, looks like iBP Power just all over this right now. And they're going to take it down. So iBP Power are going to win 16-10.